どんなふうに世の中に出ていくのか、興行も含めて、そしてどんなふうに皆様に受け入れていただけるのかは本当に想像もつきませんでした。
But with death as the theme of the film, it's true that I had no idea how this film will turn out and how it will be received by people around the world.
いろいろ悩んだり、シナリオと格闘したり、現実と格闘したりしているうちに、ある地方、日本の山形という非常に、厳しい自然の中で、こう経済的にも世界中が疲弊しているのと並行して、とても辛い現実がありましたが、その中で、必死に映画と向き合っているうちに一筋の光が見えてきたような気がします。
And I really struggled with the script and the reality of what, that the film was trying to portray, and that's when I learned about the prefecture Yamagata, which is a mountainous region in Japan with harsh climates and also just as harsh economics that people have to deal with. And I think in grappling with the reality of the people that live there, I was able to see a ray of hope and a ray of reality.
その光を与えてくれた一番大きなきっかけは、実際の農閑のシーンを我々が体験取材で何度も行きました。
And the ray of truth was found in this encoffining locale that I visited a number of times.
もちろん最初は怖かったですし、非常に妙な、気持ちでしたが、素晴らしい瞬間と出会いました。それは農閑の現実の中には音が存在しないんです。
I was very scared at first and found it to be a very strange experience, kind of learning about the whole encoffinement process. But an amazing moment happened, and that was when I found that this encoffinment process was done in complete silence.
聞こえる音というのは、絹ずれの音。あれは、お湯を汲んで、布に浸して、キュッと、水がポトンポトンポトンと落ちる音であるとか、誰かの息を殺した息遣い、そういう音だけがすごく新鮮に見えました。
And the only sound you can hear is the rustling of the fabrics and maybe the drip drop from the towels that have the hot water soaked in it and maybe the hushed voices from the people as they try to be quiet.
今現代でこんなに静かな静寂を作れる職業、そしてその空間というものに本当に感動しました。
And I was moved to find a space in Japan that where you can create such absolute silence in today's modern Japanese society, and that was a revelation to me.
何よりも、感動したのは、やはり農閑という行為を通して、亡くなられた方の人生を祝福して、そして尊敬と敬意を払って、亡くなった方を送り出すという行為は本当に美しいものに見えましたし、僕自身も感動しました。そして自分は必ずこの映画をこの年でやっと巡り合った作品だと確信しました。
And I was very moved by the whole process of encoffinment and the way you're able to celebrate the life of those who've passed and to send them off with respect. And I think that's what I was able to sort of cling on to, and I was really glad to be able to finally come across a project like this.
工業的にも最初は、どんなふうに皆さんに受け入れられるか非常に、悪戦苦闘しました。現実に公開までに13ヶ月を要しております。
And I really struggled to kind of figure out how this film will be received by the general audience, and we took a good 13 months or so to actually release the film in Japan.
それでもこの映画を見ていただいた方が、本当にいい評価というか、皆様のご意見をいただいたおかげで、日本でも想像以上に当たったし、結果として、海外の皆様にも受け入れていただいて、日本そしてアメリカの、アカデミアも受賞することができて本当に光栄です。
But I feel extremely fortunate that the film was received very favorably both by audiences and critics both in Japan.And abroad, and was very, very happy that we were able to win the Academy Award. So, I'm very, very fortunate with all of it.
特に強く思うのは、映画というのはいつどのように始まるかもわからないし、 どういうふうに育っていくかもわからない生き物のようなものだと思います。
And I feel strongly that films often feel like something organic, that you never know when it's going to be born, you never know when these ideas come.
自分の子供が一人歩きするようで、いつ終わるかもわからない、こういう映画の生き物とつけ一緒に向き合っていることが、僕にとっては今最高に面白いです。
It's as if it's a baby, and you never know when it's going to start walking. You never know when that life may be taken away, and so there's something very organic about the process of filming. The screenwriter, Kundo Koyama, who had been writing a lot of short stories before this, this is his first feature screenplay, but he has a thing for rocks. And in this film,The rock essentially becomes a symbol for everything in the film.
愛であるとか家族であるとか生きること、そして失われつつある人間関係、そして最後には命のバトンタッチ。この映画のすべての象徴です。
Be it love, family, the act of living, the fading relationships in modern society, and the baton that's being passed on from generation to generation. I think all of those things are sort of represented in the rock.Stone. And during the rehearsal process, we obviously talked a lot, but we see rehearsal as a process where we simply prepare the actors to a point where that energy that they're kind of preparing can be released during the process of filming.
脳幹視の物語ではありません。実際にお話を進めているのは脳幹視ですが、大切なことは死を目の当たりにして、ちゃんと見つめることで生きることを実感しようという映画ですね。生きることへの尊さを、への認識が大切だというテーマです。
First of all, I'd like to stress that this really isn't a film about an incoffiner or about that occupation. That may be the occupation of the characters and the protagonists especially, but what's important is thatis the process whereby they face death, come to terms with it, and thereby are able to affirm their own lives.
で、その山崎さんの演じた脳幹視の社長が、はこれは非常に重要な、位置づけにあります。それは彼は生きている大悟の父親代わりであるということです。
The important thing about the master isn't so much that he's the master as an incoffiner, but that he's really more of a father figure to Daigo, the protagonist.
そして彼は小さい頃に父親に捨てられました。しかしある強要をされたわけですね。チェリストにならなければならないという。
As a child, the protagonist was abandoned by his father and then was pressured to become a cellist.
その父親と死んだ後もなお脳幹を通して和解をするという物語です。
The story is really about Daigo and how he is able to come to terms with his own father, you know, when he's finally able to see his own dad.
そして夫婦の再生の物語です。
And it's also about how the husband and the wife are finally able to bring their marriage back together.
ですからこの特殊な脳幹という世界をいつの時代にでもある感情でありますね、悲しさ、愛情、怒り、許す、そういういつの時代にでもある普遍的な感情を通して生きることを楽しもう、前向きに生きよう、希望を持って生きようという映画です。
I think we use the encoffinment as the vehicle, but really the film is about very universal and timeless things like sadness, love, anger, forgiveness, and being able to sort of have hope and look forward and have a positive